Today I talk about magnetic topological insulators in anti-ferromagnet. This is in collaboration with Seon sitting there, and also I think this is in collaboration with Elena and Daniel. And I clearly remember, I think this project was launched at Tahiti, and in which I have attended a conference organized by Yaroslav. And then, and fortunately, I think Seon was the chair of my talk. And then after my talk, we have discussed more in detail about our project, present project. And then we have come here. And of course, after my coming back to Basel, Elena and Daniel drastically developed my project. So therefore, I also would like to sincerely thank Seon and also Elena and Daniel. So therefore, I also wish you become the next my collaborator, because in the last my conference at Tahiti, Seon was sitting here. So therefore, I also would like to collaborate with Joseph. Okay, I think my goal is very simple. So therefore, now I would like to propose magnetic topological insulators. And this is the magnetic analog of topological insulators. The point is that magnetons are the bosons. So therefore, now we theoretically propose bosonic analog of topological insulators, which is characterized by helical edge magnetic mode. I think our goal is very simple. So therefore, today I would like to show you more in detail about how to realize such magnetic topological insulators characterized by helical edge magnetic mode. I think this is the most important difference between the standard insulators and topological insulators. Okay, firstly, let's share basic idea. I think our idea is very simple. Essentially, in particular at low temperatures, anti-ferromagnet can be understood as the independent copies of ferromagnet. So therefore, we utilize this fact. So therefore, in the case of ferromagnet, this one, we have only one mode, up magnetons. But in the case of anti-ferromagnet, we have two kinds of magnetic mode, up magnetons and down magnetons, owing to this Neyl magnetic order. Of course, there's a drastic difference. In the case of ferromagnet, they have a macroscopic magnetizations. But in contrast to it, in the case of anti-ferromagnet, we don't have macroscopic magnetizations. But still, magnetron plays a key role, because there are two kinds of magnetrons, up magnetrons and down magnetrons. Then, this plays a key role of our work. That is why we can realize topological insulators, or magnetic topological insulators, characterized by helical edge magnetron mode. This is impossible in the case of ferromagnet, because in the case of ferromagnet, we have only one magnetron, up magnetrons. So therefore, even if we obtain edge mode, the edge mode is chiral, only one direction. But in contrast to it, in the case of anti-ferromagnet, we have two kinds of magnetrons, up magnetrons and down magnetrons. So therefore, by making cyclotron motion, we can realize helical edge magnetron mode. That is, of course, both magnetrons propagate along the edge of samples, but the direction is opposite. This is nothing but helical edge. So therefore, today I would like to show you more in detail how to realize such magnetic topological insulators. I think this is a very intuitive picture of such dynamics. So therefore, making cyclotron motion, we can obtain one chiral edge magnetron mode as follows. Up magnetrons propagate along these lines. Of course, the point is that in the bulk, they cancel with each other. So therefore, in the bulk, there are no interacting phenomena. But still, owing to this cyclotron motion, we can obtain this interacting chiral edge magnetron mode, which propagate along one direction. This is the up magnetron. But the point is that using down magnetrons, we can create same cyclotron motions. But the point is, direction is opposite. So that is why we can create chiral edge magnetron mode. But the point is, opposite directions. So therefore, in anti-ferromagnet, we can realize helical edge magnetron mode. Now, let me stress. We focus on single layer. Single layered anti-ferromagnet, not bilayer. Then we can realize helical edge magnetron mode, which is topologically protected. I think this is our main conclusion or highlight. Then the point is that how to create such cyclotron motions. Then our answer is a Hahn-Kasha phase, which magnons acquire geometric phase in electric field. In this talk, I provide more in detail about how to realize such helical magnon mode. Actually, in the last hour work, I have theoretically proposed how to create something like quantum Hall effect, which is characterized by chiral edge magnon mode. The point is that owing to electrically induced Hahn-Kasha phase, we can create such cyclotron motions. But the point is that in the bulk, they cancel with each other. But still, edge mode survive. And thus, we can create chiral edge magnon mode in ferromagnet using a Hahn-Kasha effect. This is something like topological ferromagnet. Then we develop it into anti-ferromagnet. Then, as explained, due to the opposite directions of cyclotron motions, we can create helical edge magnon mode as follows. So far, this is the highlight of my talk. Today, I will show you more in detail about this phenomena. And we believe this is something like magnetic topological insulators, which is characterized by helical edge magnon mode in single layered anti-ferromagnet. And actually, I think I have shown this animation with my colleagues and Niels. Okay, I will tell you the name is Niels. And then Niels told me, oh, have you made something like Mario game? And then I have said yes. And so therefore, I think along the edge, Mario and Luigi propagate, but opposite directions. This is the intuitive understanding of such helical edge magnon mode. And actually, I think this helical edge magnon mode is very robust against non-magnetic impurities. So therefore, I think still we can explain what is a helical edge magnon mode using Mario game. And actually, I think Seon's kids has already understood what is a helical edge magnon mode using these animations. Okay, let me summarize my purpose of my talk. Today, I would like to share my qualitative understanding of how to realize such helical edge magnon mode using anti-ferromagnet, not ferromagnet. Then the key point is that we use a Hahn-Kasha phase, which can be created by applying electric field. Then we theoretically propose how to realize such magnetic topological insulators in anti-ferromagnet. The point is helical edge magnon mode, which is characterized by topological invariant or Chern integers. Then using such topological invariant, we investigate also topological Hall effect of bulk magnons, such as spin thermal and Lennard's effect. And then on top of it, we theoretically propose what is the universality of bosonic Wiedemann-Franz law, that is, magnetic Wiedemann-Franz law. We theoretically show you universal thermomagnetic properties. Okay, this is my purpose of my talk. And actually, my talk is arranged as follows. Firstly, I discuss in detail about topological phenomena, topological ferromagnet induced by a Hahn-Kasha phase. And then later, using that fact, we developed it into topological anti-ferromagnet. And then we can show you how to create such helical edge magnon mode. Okay, let's start. I think, as you know, magnon plays a key role in the transport of heat and magnet in insulating magnet. And the ferromagnet or anti-ferromagnet does not matter. In any cases, I think it plays a key role for low energy collecting excitations. And thus, magnons carry magnet as well as heat. Then we use this fact. And then the question is that, can magnon transport be similar to electrons? I believe this is a very fundamental question, because electrons are fermions, but magnons are bosons. Those statistical properties are different. But still, I would like to ask you this crazy question. Can magnon transport be similar to electrons? Then our answer is yes. We found several magnon counterparts, magnetic analog, such as magnetic Wiedemann-Franz law, magnetic Josephson effect, and magnetic quantum Hall effect, which is characterized by chiral edge magnon mode. And now we theoretically propose magnetic topological insulators, characterized by helical edge magnon mode. This is the clear correspondence between electron transport and magnon transport. And then, in our work, a Hadron cluster phase plays a key role. And fortunately, also experimentally, such a Hadron cluster effect on magnons have been experimentally observed recently by Yale group. So therefore, this experimental progress strongly supports our theoretical work. And also, I would like to remark, until now, we have focused on ferromagnet, which has macroscopic magnetations. Then now, we switch into antiferromagnet, in which we cannot find any macroscopic magnetations. But still, we can find very interesting phenomena, such as magnetic topological insulators. Today, I would like to show you more in detail about helical edge magnon mode, which characterizes magnetic topological insulators. Okay, to this end, let me explain what is the feature of topological ferromagnet. And our strategy is very straightforward. We develop magnetic classical Hall effect in Hadron cluster phase into magnetic quantum Hall effect, which is characterized by chiral edge magnon mode. Our strategy is very straightforward. Using topological descriptions based on topological invariant, Chern integers or TKNN number, we develop this classical Hall effect into quantum Hall effect. The big difference is that in the case of classical Hall effect, we cannot find any topological edge. But still, based on topological descriptions, we find chiral edge magnon mode in such topological ferromagnet induced by a Hadron cluster phase. And on top of it, we further develop it into antiferromagnet. And then we have theoretically proposed how to realize helical edge magnon mode, which can be understood as a magnetic topological insulator. The key point is G2 topological number induced by G's guides. And then I would like to show you more in detail about each strategy. And to this project, a Hadron cluster phase plays a key role. I think the correspondence between a Hadron cluster phase and a Hadron bone phase is very straightforward and very clear. And in the case of magnons, magnons are essentially magnetic dipole, which is characterized by Bohr magneton. So therefore, of course, it's coupled with electric field. And then such acquired geometric fields can be characterized as flows. This is the Bohr magneton, and this is the externally applied electric field. And then we can introduce something like electric vector potential defined as flows. So that is why the expression becomes qualitatively identical. This is the Hadron-Bohm phase, and this is the Hadron-Kirchhoff phase. And then we can use same strategies. Actually, the point is that applying electric field gradient, epsilon, we can obtain this straightforward correspondence. In the case of Hadron-Bohm phases, magnetic field perpendicular to the system plays a key role to create cyclotron motions. However, in the case of a Hadron cluster phase, electric field gradient plays a key role. Of course, qualitatively, it is different. But mathematically, the correspondence is straightforward or identical. So therefore, using this correspondence, we develop classical Hall effect into quantum Hall effect. And furthermore, we develop it into magnetic topological insulators. And actually, this is the outline, this is the highlight of my work on topological ferromagnet. The key point is that, as explained, we apply electric field gradient, then which satisfies these conditions. So that is why, similarly to electrons, they perform cyclotron motions at flows, which can be characterized by using this frequency. Now it is apparent, if we apply uniform electric field, we cannot obtain such cyclotron motions or Landau levels. Owing to this epsilon electric field gradient, we can obtain such cyclotron motions or Landau levels. This is the importance of electric field gradient, not uniform electric field. And then they form Landau levels. So that is why we can expect quantum Hall effect. And now let me stress. Using scarmion lattice induced by the Lurkin-Skinner-Monier interactions, we can expect the similar phenomena. Also in this case, Kevin has microscopically derived lambda gap, which can be estimated as plots. So this means some spin structure also provide us something like vector potential, analyzes this vector potential. Today, I would like to focus on this externally applied electric field gradient. Okay, then we have seen that owing to Ahern-Cassia phase, magnons perform cyclotron motions. And then, as explained, the point is that in the bulk, they cancel with each other. So far, in the bulk, there are no interesting phenomena, but still, we can find survived mode, which should be identified with chiral edge magnon mode. This means, using Ahern-Cassia phase, we can create such chiral edge magnon mode. So far, such ferromagnet in Ahern-Cassia phase or in electric field can be understood as a topological ferromagnet. Actually, this is the numerical demonstrations. And then the Hamiltonian let us plot and very simple, and during this hopping process, magnons acquire Ahern-Cassia phase in electric field. And then we have numerically plotted energy as a function of wave vectors. And then the point is that it is clear we have obtained chiral edge magnon mode or chiral edge up magnon mode. This is the right moving and this is the left moving. And so this numerical we have obtained such chiral edge magnon mode using Ahern-Cassia phase. Now let me explain more in detail. Owing to this Ahern-Cassia phase, we obtained almost flat band. That is, this bandwidth is much smaller than lambda energy gap, which we call almost flat band. This brings us Chern number in Hall coefficient. Okay, let me remark about it. Using bulk edge correspondence, we found chiral edge magnon mode bring us Chern integers, which is characterized as plots. Then we found only in the case of almost flat band, Hall transport coefficient also becomes characterized by Chern integers. Now let me stress, in the case of electrons, they have a sharp Fermi surface. So that is why, in the case of fermions, they are easily connected by Chern integers. But in the case of bosons or magnons, we don't have such Fermi surface, which is characterized by both distribution functions. So therefore, generally, in the case of magnons or bosons, Hall transport coefficient cannot be characterized by using Chern integers. But only in the case of almost flat band, it becomes characterized by Chern integers. This plays a key role. Actually, we have microscopically evaluated each Onsager coefficient using the result by Matsumoto-san and Murakami-san. And then we have microscopically derived the explicit form of this each Onsager coefficient. And then using this result, we have numerically plotted the ratio between thermal Hall conductance to magnetic Hall conductance as the function of inverse temperatures. And then it is clear, at low temperatures, the ratio becomes constant, in which magnetic Wiedemann-Hans law is realized. That is, also in the case of magnons, the ratio between thermal Hall conductance to magnetic Hall conductance becomes proportional to temperature. Remember, magnons are bosons. So therefore, at least for us, this is very surprising. Because I think, as you know, Wiedemann-Hans law characterizes the thermoelectric transport properties of electrons, but electrons are fermions. But magnons are bosons, so the statistical properties are different. But still, at low temperatures, they show the same temperature dependence, linear in temperatures. So therefore, we believe this is nothing but universality. Okay, then also in terms of coefficient, apart from G factors, it does not depend on any materials. So in this sense, also this something like magnon Lorentz number also can be understood as something like universal properties. Now let me remark one point. In the case of magnons, we should use original definitions of thermal conductivities, which is by definition originally defined by using all on-saga coefficient. As well as L22, this off-diagonal element plays a key role. Physically, this explains counter current induced by magnetization gradient due to applied thermal gradient. Now let me stress, in the case of magnons or bosons, we should not use this conventional definition of thermal hole conductance or thermal conductance. We should use original definitions of thermal conductance defined as follows. I explain more in detail about this method. But please remember one point. In the case of magnons, if we wrongly omit this off-diagonal element, this Biedermann-Hahn's law cannot be restored. This is the importance of off-diagonal element or such non-equilibrium effect. And I believe such magnetic Biedermann-Hahn's law is surely already expand the reach, because last decade has seen very rapid and drastic development of experiment magnon spin tonics, such as spin JPEG effect, spin wave spin current, magnon thermal hole effect, and Aharon-Kesha effect, and Snell's law, and magnetic spin conductivities, and magnon planar hole effect. So therefore, using this experimental approach, we believe our theoretical proposal, magnetic Biedermann-Hahn's law, is surely already experimental reach. Okay, this is the end of my talk about topological ferromagnet. Okay, then let me remark one point about thermal conductance for bosons. I think you might expect thermal conductance is defined as follows. That is, L22 component can be understood as a thermal conductance. But now let me stress, this is applicable only to electrons which has sharp Fermi surface. That is, originally, thermal conductance is defined by using all elements. I think you can find such discussions in the textbook of standard textbook by Ashokrishna Marmin, in which thermal conductance is defined as follows. But the point is that in the case of electrons, they have sharp Fermi surface. So that is why contributions coming from off-diagonal element becomes negligibly small due to Fermi energies. That is, even at room temperatures, these contributions become negligibly small. So that is why, conventionally, L22 can be understood as a thermal conductance, but only electrons in metals. Because in insulators, or in the case of magnons, they don't have such Fermi surface. Magnons are bosons. So that is why we should use original definitions defined as follows. And physically or qualitatively, it can be understood as follows. And I think this discussion is based on measurement. And actually, in order to measure thermal conductivities, we apply thermal gradient. And then particles flow from here to here. And as a result, there is a magnetization gradient, which produces, of course, countercurrent. That is, due to this applied thermal gradient, magnetization gradient is developed. Then, of course, this magnetization gradient works as an effective magnetic field. So that is why it produces counter heat current. So that is why, in the expression of thermal conductance, off-diagonal element appears. Of course, this is applicable also to electrons. But in the case of electrons, these contributions simply mathematically negligibly small. So that is why L22 can be understood as a conventional definition or expression of thermal conductance. However, magnons are bosons, so that is why we should use original definitions of this thermal conductance, which is defined by using all elements. We need all 2x2 on-saga matrix to evaluate thermal conductance. I think you can find more nice discussions about the paper by Johnson, Silsby, and also Bass. Okay, I think this is an important remark from me. Okay, then finally, let's move to topological anti-ferromagnet. Okay, then let me confirm our strategies. Until now, we have developed classical Hall effect in Aharon-Kesha phase into quantum Hall effect in ferromagnet, using topological invariant. in which we found chiral edge magnetic mode. So therefore, using this similar approach, we develop this quantum Hall effect into quantum spin Hall effect, or magnetic topological insulators, which is characterized by helical edge magnetic mode. The point is, now we use anti-ferromagnet. So therefore, we have two kinds of magnets, up magnets and down magnets. Then, making them cyclotron motions, we can obtain helical edge magnetic mode. Okay, as explained, the key point is that, in particular at low temperatures, anti-ferromagnet can be understood as the independent copies of ferromagnet. So therefore, we obtain two kinds of magnets, up magnets and down magnets. Then, making them cyclotron motions, we can obtain, or we can expect, helical edge magnetic mode. Okay, and then this is the schematic picture of my theoretical work. Up magnets flow along the edge of sample one direction, but down magnets propagate along the edge of samples but opposite directions. And thus, we can obtain helical edge magnetic mode using a Hahn-Kescher effect. Okay, actually, this is a numerical plot. And this is the Hamiltonian, and then the point is that during this hopping process, magnets acquire a Hahn-Kescher phase, but they obtain opposite sign a Hahn-Kescher phase. The sign of a Hahn-Kescher phase is opposite between up magnets and down magnets. And thus, we have obtained this helical edge magnetic mode. Red line shows the up spin magnets, and blue line shows the down spin magnets. This is the right moving, and this is the left moving. And also this is the right moving, and this is the left moving. And then we obtain helical edge magnetic mode as plots. Now let me stress. Now we focus on single layered ferromagnet, not bilayer. Thus, this is nothing but helical edge magnetic mode. And then using bulk edge correspondence, we can obtain this information about chain integers. Because the direction of cyclotron motions or edge mode is opposite. So that is why chain integer also becomes opposite. In the case of up magnets, it becomes 1. But in the case of up down magnets, chain integer becomes minus 1. And so therefore, it can be summarized as follows, which characterizes surely helical edge magnetic mode, depicted here. And then the point is that, of course, total chain integer becomes 0. Net chain integer vanish. But still, these topological invariant or these topological integer is defined or given as plots. So that is why this is nothing but magnetic topological insulators. And then also using bulk edge correspondence, we have microscopically evaluated each Onsager coefficient. And then the point is that off-diagonal element vanish due to these conditions. But off-diagonal element becomes non-zero due to this topological invariant. That is, I think as you know, spin-Nernst effect is expressed as follows, or defined here. And then we found spin-Nernst effect is ensured by this topological invariant. Finally, let me ask you this question. I wonder, magnetic Wiedemann-Hahn law is realized or satisfied also in insulating anti-ferromagnet? This is the last answer we should reply. Then our answer is no. In the case of topological anti-ferromagnet or magnetic topological insulator, I have explained. Because in the case of topological insulators, spin Hall conductance and thermal Hall conductance vanish due to this relation between topological invariant. So that is why, in the case of magnetic topological insulators, Wiedemann-Hahn law becomes ill-defined or violated. But in the case of non-topological anti-ferromagnet, standard anti-ferromagnet, magnetic Wiedemann-Hahn law surely does hold as follows. The point is that anti-ferromagnet identical The reason is very simple. Because anti-ferromagnet can be understood as an independent copy of ferromagnet. So therefore, anti-ferromagnet or ferromagnet does not matter in the bulk. They satisfy identical magnetic field magnetic law defined as follows. So therefore, let me remind you, there is a sharp difference between topological anti-ferromagnet and non-topological anti-ferromagnet in terms of thermomagnetic properties or field magnetic law. Okay, and then, as explained, now we have theoretically proposed magnetic counterpart of topological insulators, which can be understood as a bosonic analog of standard topological insulators. Proposed more than 10 years. Okay, let me summarize my talk. We have theoretically proposed how to realize helical edge magnon mode, which can be understood as a magnonic topological insulator. And then the key point is Aharon-Kesha effect. Using Aharon-Kesha effect, we have theoretically demonstrated helical edge magnon mode is realized in such topological anti-ferromagnet. And also the point is that such topological anti-ferromagnet can be characterized by using this G2 topological invariant. And then we have theoretically clarified magnonic spin density effect is characterized or ensured by such topological G2 invariant. Okay, this is the end of my talk. Thank you very much for your attention.